Today we're going to be playing The Evolution of Trust by Nicky Chase. It's approximately 30 minutes long, so let's see how it plays. And your total score is 34, which is pretty good. The lowest highest possible scores are 7 and 47 respectively. So who are the strange characters you just played against? Poppycat. Hello, I just started with cooperate, and afterwards I just copy whatever you did in the last round. Meow. Roger. Was a partner. I'll start cooperating and keep cooperating. But if you ever cheat me, I'll cheat you back to the end of tarnation. Always cheat. The strong shall eat the weak. Always cooperate. Let's be best friends. Detective. First I'll analyze you. Start, cooperate, cheat, cooperate, cooperate. If you cheat back, I'll act like copycat. If you never cheat, I'll act like always cheat to exploit you. Elementary, my dear Watson. Now, if those characters put a play against each other, it's tournament time. Each character will now play against every other player. That's 10 paired matches and 10 rounds per matches. Who do you think with the highest total score? Think carefully about it and then place your bets. I'll go with Grudger. Alright, you place a bet on Grudger. Let's go through the matches one by one and see how the tournaments play out. Match 1 is Copycat versus Always Cheat. By the way, Copycat won. Copycat always versus corporate. You may be skeptical about what Christmas truce story about the World War I trenches. Surely it was just a fluke. Copycat versus Grudger. Yes, the truth was dramatic, but it wasn't neither unique nor unusual. Not every trench joined in the piece, but it was pretty widespread. Many front lines came up with an idea independently and again, despite specific strict orders not to. Copycat versus Detective. Always Cheap versus Always Corporate. Even before Christmas, the Shovel front lines had already established an unofficial secret peace. Always Cheat versus Grudger. They call it the live and let live system. Faithfully, you don't shoot me, I don't shoot you, and this works in lots of places. May still be skeptical. Many soldiers didn't spontaneously form peace with the enemies. What was the special trench warfare? Here's what's unique about the trenchers. Unlike almost every other forms of war, you had to face the same specific soldiers every day. It's a repeated game, and it makes all the difference. And anyway, the winner is... Copycat. Apologies for your bet grudge. Copycat goes by many names. The Golden Rule, Reciprocal Altruisms, Tit for Tat, or Live and Let Live. That's why peace should emerge in the trenches of World War I, when you were forced to play the same game with the same specific people, not the same generic enemy, over and over again. Copycat does not just win the battle, it wins the war. But if things change a lot when you play multiple rounds of the same game, if we played multiple tournaments. Now let our population of players evolve over time. The three-step dance. Play tournament. Let them all play against each other and tell up their scores. Eliminate losers. Get rid of the 5 worst players. If it's a tie, pick 5 randomly between them. 3. Reproduce winners. Clone the best 5 best players. If there's a tie, pick randomly between them. And repeat for as long as you like. Note, you don't have to wait for people to literally die and reproduce for culture to evolve. All that's needed is that successful behaviors go away and successful behaviors are animated. Now, let's see this in action. Let's say we start with the following population of players. 15 always cooperates, 5 always cheats, and 5 copycats. We'll ignore Grudger and Detective for now. We're going to do the tournament eliminate reproduce dance a dozen times or so. Let's make another bet. Think will win the first tournament, place your bet again. Makes sense. Copycat won the tournament last time. Why not again? Let's see if you're correct. copycat did not win, but at least they didn't do as bad as Always Cooperate. They got eaten up by Always Cheat. Those numbers have now increased by 5. Let's play a few more rounds of this. Always Cheat is still growing at the expense of Always Cooperate. And now, all the Always Cooperate are dead, but wait. That's right, the Always Cheat becomes a victim of their own success. They exploit the native Always Cooperators. But once they ran out of them, they had to face the copycats, who are nice, but not naive. By simply copying the other player's moves, copycats can play nice with each other, while Always Copycats just cheat themselves. Not only that, but it also means copycat can give Always Cheats a taste of their own medicine. And so as a result, copycat inherits the earth. In a long way, you are right, copycat always wins. Always Cheats may have won in the short run, but its exploitativeness was its downfall, which reminds me of the quote, "We are punished by our sins, not for them." Albert Hubbard. By the way, this attack was similar, even we put Grudger and Detective back in. No, sometimes a few Grudgers may stick around because when all players except Grudger and Copycat are eliminated, the two tie. So, it seems the math of the game theory is telling you something. A copycat's philosophy, do unto others as you would have them do unto you, may not just be a moral truth, but also a mathematical truth. However, there's a problem. Look around. The world's full of total jerkwads. Copycat is this, and the strategy of this repeated game of Frost that's so powerful. That even soldiers of World War II trench once independently evolved a similar strategy called Live and Let Live. Why then are there so many untrustworthy people that's causing our epidemic of untrust? Include that sentence itself in this repeated game of trust. So far we've only talked about change in the players. What about change in the game? What would that lead to? The evolution of distrust? Everything goes to heck. Let's start with something nice. Here's a world full of entirely Always Cooperates, except for one Always Cheats and one Copycat. Use the button to start the sim. Go through the separate set, or just reset it. As you always know, Copycat wins handily in the long run under our current rules. That's under our current rules, which says players play against each other for 10 rounds per match. Does Copycat still win for 7 rounds, 5 rounds, 3, 2, 1? Start the number of rounds with a slider around below, then start the sim and see what happens. Feel free to experiment. Excuse one second. I'll be playing this without peeking right now. As you saw, if you don't play enough rounds, here 5 or less, Always Cheats dominates. In 1985, when Americans were asked how many close friends they had, the most common answer was 3. In 2004, the most common answer was 0. We now have fewer friends across class, race, racial, economic, and political lines because we have fewer friends, period. And, as you discover for yourself, with fewer repeat interactions there are, the more distrust will spread. No, mass media doesn't count. It must be two-way interaction between the specific individuals. Oh, and it gets worse. This is another way of three distrust. Here are the payoffs for the trust game. With a normal payoff, copycat wins. Now, change the both cooperate rewards from +2 to +1 and click start. Even though +1 is still more than the punishment for both cheating, 0, what happens? The same thing happens with a lower win-win reward, always cheat take over. Game theory has two powerful ideas about this. The sum-zero game, this is sadly common belief, that a gain for us must come at a loss to them and vice versa. Non-zero-sum game, this is when people make the hard effort to create a win-win situation, or at least avoid a lose-lose. Without the non-zero-sum game, trust cannot evolve. Speaking of which, let's now look at our third and final barrier to the evolution of mistrust, mistakes. Mistakes. As cool as copycat is, it has a huge fatal weakness. I haven't mentioned yet. I understand the problem. Let's say two copycats are playing against each other. Being nice players, both of the moves will be cooperate. And normally, they just pay back each other's kindness and sing kumbaya until the end of time. But what if while trying to reciprocate goodness? Oh no, mistakes and communication, misinterpretations, accidents happen all the time in real life. The other person doesn't think is an accident. Oh no, times two. The other player, being a copycat, had to retaliate, and you, being a copycat, as it will also have to retaliate. It's like the hands of your voice. These two copycats aspire into a cycle of vengeance, which start over single stage long ago. Tragic. Now there are other types of players who can deal with mistakes. Let's meet a few new kick faces, or new hats anyways. Copy Kitten. Hello, I'm like Copy Cat, except I cheat back only after you cheat me twice in a row. After all, the first one could be a mistake. Simpleton. Hi. Try start to cooperate. If you cooperate back, I do the same thing as the last move. Even with a mistake. If you cheat back, I do opposite thing as last move. Even if it's a mistake. Random. Robot. Monkey. Robot. Ninja Pizza Tacos. LOL. I'm so random. Just play cheat or cooperate randomly with a 50-50 chance. Alright. Let's see how well these peeps do when they play a new test. Let's start with a dozen always cooperates versus our old winner, the Air Copycat, and our three new characters. The Forgiving Copycat, the Dull Simpleton, and the Random Zodi Random. In each round of a match, players have a small chance to make a mistake, let's say 5%. Who do you think will come out on top? Copy Kittens. Alright, you bet Copy Kittens win. Let's find out. Use the control scene left to start the sim in a quick mode or go through step by step. Your bet was close, but no cigar. Simpleton wins. That's because Simpleton is actually capable of exploiting always cooperates. They both start cooperating, but if Simpleton makes a mistake, it cheats. And always cooperate never retaliates. It'll keep cheating them. Let's try. Same thing as before, except instead of always cooperates, have always cheats. It's a much less friendly, more hostile environment. Who do you think will win now? Right on the money. Copycat wins this time. Oh, there's still some there. That's a Kinnon is so forgiving and doesn't even entirely wipe out Copycat and Shira's room. In this case, a bit of miscommunication that presents chances of mistake each round could lead to more forgiveness. But is this true at all levels of miscommunication? Use this letter below to change the amount of miscommunication in his start. 5% Copycat wins. How about 0%, or 20%, or 50%? It only goes to 50%, because at that point, every move is a point flip. During each round, there's 5% chance the player makes a mistake. Copycat's inherent to her. It's about even, but Copy Kinnon's inherent. The result turns out something like this. At 0%, the fair Copycat wins. At 1-9%, the Copycat wins. Turned to 49%, the unfair forgiving always cheats wins. 3%, nobody wins. That is why miscommunication is such an interesting barrier to trust. A little bit of it leads to forgiveness, but too much, it leads to widespread distrust. I think our modern media technology, as much as it helps us increase communication, and then increase our miscommunication much more. At last, let's experiment with all the numbers, the knobs, the sliders, let's play in the sandbox mode. Thank you. interactions. Trust keeps the relationship going, but you need the knowledge of possible future repeat interactions before the trust can evolve. 2. Possible win-wins. You must be playing a non-zero game sum game. A game where it's the least possible that both players can get better off. A win-win. Low miscommunication. If the level of miscommunication is too high, trust breaks down. When there's a little bit of miscommunication, it pays to be more forgiving. Of course, real-world trust is affected by much more than this. There is reputation, shared values, contracts, cultural markers, blah blah blah. But let's not forget the biggest one. If there is one big takeaway from all the game theory, it's this. What the game is defines what other players do. Our problem today isn't just that people are losing trust, it's that our environment acts against the evolution of trust. It may seem clinical or naive that we are merely products of our environment, as game theory reminds us, we are such each other's environment. In the short run, the game defines the players. In the long run, us players define the game. So, do what you can do to create the conditions necessary to evolve trust for relationships, find win-wins, communicate clearly, and then we can stop firing at each other, get out of our own trenches, cross into no man's land, and come together and all learn to live and let live. Thank you for watching. I will be playing putting the link in the description. So, I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.